why do we go through Yama Dwar? You saw the picture. Prakash was showing you the picture of Yama Dwar. What is Yama? Yama is the contract of time which we have taken in this birth. Yama is the time contract. We have a contract with time. I will use this body in this life this much time. Like you buy, you take a rent a car. You sign the agreement saying that I want this car for this duration of time. Like that, you have an agreement with the existence for keeping this body for certain experiences. It could be good, bad or ugly experiences. But the reason why you have a body is because you demanded certain experiences from life. There is nothing good or bad about it. Don't even judge. This is all in the mind. Whatever you came for, you will get at that point in time. Now somebody will say that was good, that was bad. That is their problem. But you will get what you deserve. So Yama Dwar is the gateway of time. You cross through Yama Dwar, leave behind something from you. People leave behind their pictures, money, something on the other side. What does that signify? That you are leaving behind your past. What you carry, sometimes people leave their dress, not what you're wearing, something else. What all things you leave behind, Sumit?
Handkerchief,
pictures.
Money.
Yeah.
Business cards.
Yeah, if you reach business cards. Yeah, the buffalo should not lose its way. Yeah. Some people leave my picture behind because they want to run away from me. This is a good idea. Get rid of Mohanji, I'm in liberation. Yeah. I heard something very funny. Mohanji is an individual. I do not want to connect to an individual. This was very funny for me because you know what? There's no individual apart from the tradition ever. Any master you take. You take any master. What does the master represent? Usually, every master represents the path of liberation. Then why do you have teachers in the school? To show you the way to reach the degree classes or get graduated. That is all more or less the same job which every master does. Only thing is that you get graduated from life to eternity. This is the difference. So, what is my significance in this? I have no significance. This is a perishable body just like yours. There's nothing great about this body. So if the mind is saying, I do not want to follow a physical form, I would only say this is stupidity. It's not the physical form you're following. You're not following me. You're not doing what I'm doing. You're following path of liberation in which I'm giving you clarity. You're following yourself. You are liberation, not me. I'm just a mirror showing you your own picture. And who runs me? Who projects me? Tradition projects me, not me projecting anybody. Or I cannot project myself. What can I project? What do you project in this world? Your personality, nothing else you are projecting. People say, I know this person because they recognize a personality. You are projecting nothing else in this world. Think about it. Likewise, what is Mohanji projecting? Personality. But beyond the personality, what I talk, what I do, or whatever I express, for your sake, that is the tradition. I have nothing to do with that way. That means personality has nothing to do with the tradition. I may have a particular taste for a particular food. That has nothing to do with the tradition. That's the personality, just like you. So, leave behind something which is yours. I'm not yours. So, I belong to the world. You leave something behind as a confirmation that you're ready to transcend. Then you cross, there's a bell to ring. Then you cross to the others. Three times you take circles of Yama Dwar, which is you're actually detaching from this existence. Then you enter the Yama Dwar. Before that you leave something behind. Enter the Yama Dwar, ring the bell, go to the other side, from time to eternity. That means it's like a death of past to the future. Then you start walking, because with all your baggages you cannot enter the zone of Shiva. Shiva is liberation. You leave behind your baggage and enter the zone of Shiva.